I wish to, it's my intention to make an informed plea of guilty, but I have not yet been informed as to the cause of each of the proceedings.
Okay.
Perfect response, hero. So the judge says, well, what do you mean by informed? And our hero completely ignores his question, which is perfectly fine to do because God knows, obviously, they ignore ours, and just goes right back to some meat and potatoes. Yeah? I intend to plead guilty as long as I can be informed of the cause and nature of the proceedings. And that's brave as shit with big boy pants on, because he just got done saying it's my intention, getting cut off with a troll attempt that didn't work and went nowhere, Judge Johnston, by the way. About, I don't care what your intentions are, you have to answer my question. And it's gonna get hotter in temperature in here if you don't. That's the most ridiculous line I've heard so far.
We have been, we're past that. And,
oh yeah, you have been informed, we're past that. Really? You know good and well evidence of jurisdiction is part of being informed.
You don't get to object. You don't get to object to me.
He didn't object to you. This is nothing more than a troll attempt, and I would be trying to contain my laughter. My laughter at your pathetic 2-year-old temper tantrums, Judge Johnston. He just asks a question, again, trying to troll, lets our hero put out 2 or 3 words, and interrupts him with some bullshit. You don't get to object. You don't get to object to me. What the hell does that mean? A, it's total nonsense lie. Anybody can object over anything relevant anytime they want, and you have to put up with it. And if you don't, it's your ass in a federal lawsuit and in front of the Superior Court judges, where your discretion is no longer applicable. Another judge will be looking at this transcript. You are supposed to pretend to be fair, balanced, independent, impartial, and unbiased, and you can't do one of the 5. I'm threatening your paycheck through the weight of public opinion only. Welcome to YouTube, motherfucker. I can see why you're so afraid of it.
You can object to other individuals, other proceedings. You don't get to object to me.
He didn't try to object to you. You're putting words in his mouth that he didn't say and then throwing a temper tantrum over it? Please. You don't think he's going to see that tactic coming a million miles away? Did you not listen to how he destroyed Judge Gaston? Did you not listen to that? We're not going to stop coming.
No. No.
Another troll attempt. Another troll attempt. You don't get to object to me. Well, okay, I won't say the word objection. Then our hero says a point of clarification. And again, the troll. It doesn't even matter what words come out. No, no, no. Judge Johnston, I'm going to give the viewers and listeners here a little lesson on objecting. Okay, just to counter your BS here so they don't have to put up with this in the future. If a defendant, quote unquote, does not object, okay, they can't even be held accountable for understanding what you're saying in the courtroom because they can't clarify what you're saying. You're trying to force people to answer questions that they don't understand, comprehend, okay? You're being vague in your questions, and when they ask for clarification, you refuse to let them? It would be shirking one's duty to allow a lie to go in the transcript unchallenged. It would be lazy of a defendant to not object. You cannot, as powerful as you are, take away someone's right to object permanently. Oh, you can do it whenever you want, little courtroom, because your courtroom's full of nothing but fellow bribed pussies in uniforms like bailiffs and clerks. But you can't do it long term, and you're not going to get away with it.
Well, you can answer my question. You're on thin ice. Do you want to spend some more time in jail?
Oh, you're on thin ice. Do you want to spend some more time in jail? Yeah, they put our hero in jail. And for challenging jurisdiction, he was in there for, I think, just a day. It wasn't long. Just hours. It wasn't 2 days, that's for sure. Okay? And you know what they did during that time? They made him get completely naked, front and back. That's a strip search for challenging jurisdiction. That's evil. That's so criminal, it's not even funny.
I'm more than happy to do that. And it isn't going to be one day. It's going to be a lot more days if you've got enough of the time on your hands.
He just threatened him with throwing him in jail, not just one day, but many days, for saying what? Point of clarification. That's the last thing our hero said. Point of clarification, and he just got threatened with many days in jail.
You can do that, but you horsed around and screwed around.
Objection, point of clarification. Can you please define horsed around and screwed around? Because I can't find those in the Black's Law Dictionary, and the appellate panel's going to want to know what you're talking about. Of course, he'll never let our hero get that out on the record, and saying such a thing right now is risking jail. And so you shouldn't say that. You shouldn't risk jail. Obviously, he's so close to throwing him in jail just for an arbitrary, oh no, you're horsing around, you're being irrelevant, you're wasting the court's time, you're preventing me from doing my job. Contempt. Give him 7 days to think about it, and anyone else who might think about going down this path of challenging jurisdiction. This is the United States of America. It's a f***ing police state backed up by these black robes.
And enough is enough. So, how do you proceed? I'm giving you your option.
Objection, point of clarification. Based on the transcript, it seems that the options that you're giving me are to go to jail or to lie. Which one would you like me to do? What are you talking about? I'm not asking you to lie. You're asking me to sign a plea of guilty and not guilty that's uninformed and absent a crucial element of the crime, specifically the evidence of jurisdiction. Really, when a judge gets this serious, to the viewers, in all seriousness, I want to take a time out and say, if you get threatened by a judge in this manner, your best option, when he threatens violence and jail like that, is to remain silent until he asks why you're remaining silent. And say, I don't wish to stand mute. I wish to have the right to defend myself. I wish to exercise that right. However, I cannot do so with a judge who is threatening me with violence if I don't lie on the record. And say it like you're being bullied, not with the anger in my voice. Okay, so if you're listening to this and you get threatened that quickly to jail, you've got to play the bully victim. Do not come out angry and swinging. We have now crossed the line into psycho land where he's going to put you in jail. And I don't want anybody going to jail because they listened to one of my videos. Okay? It's all about mitigating violence. Don't go to jail. It's no loss to remain silent and then bang the hammer and say, case closed, next case. And then you walk out in silence. That is a victory. I mean, really, at the point where they threaten you with violence like this, you can really just forget this evidence of jurisdiction stuff and start calling out exactly what's going on. Do I have the right to defend myself? If they say yes, do I have the right to speak without interruption and threats of violence if it's relevant? Yes. Okay, well, apparently I don't because it hasn't been allowed so far. I'm going to try again. If I get interrupted in making relevant points in the future, I would like you to point out exactly where I lost this right, because you just said I had it, so let's try this again. Has the prosecutor submitted evidence of jurisdiction, yes or no? You know what I mean? But again, don't get crazy with this psycho.
Then, I will make a decision under duress.
Smart. Smart, hero. I don't mind him, obviously, I just said, I don't mind him abandoning the evidence thing of jurisdiction, because he's constantly being threatened with violence, and this judge is hell-bent on either winning or throwing him in jail, and so obviously you can't win, and so now our hero's going, all right, well, I'm going to make a decision under duress. Let's see where it goes.
Go ahead. What is your decision?
The judge just said, go ahead. What's your decision? Like, as if he doesn't have a problem with him making a decision under duress. Judge obviously doesn't give about the word duress. The word duress means that you're now having to do something that you would never normally do because someone's threatening you with violence. Plain and simple.
I'll enter an uninformed plea of not guilty.
So he enters an uninformed plea of not guilty. Yeah, this is a guy who needs to put his big boy pants on. He's taking on a dangerous, violent gang member. And this hearing was from almost, let's call it, 3 weeks ago. And he had only been on the game for a month. And he's coming at him with this level of courage and bravery?
Alright, then we'll set this matter for trial.
So the judge is perfectly content with that. I'm going to enter an uninformed plea of not guilty. And the judge is, okay, great, well then let's set this matter for trial. And he's going to get real back to normal now.
And we'll go from there.
And we'll go from there.
Thank you very much, Mr. Escobar.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Your Honor. Deputy, there is pending discovery. We're waiting on receiving some videos and stuff like that from Portland Airport. It may take a little additional time, so I ask that the trial may be moved out a little further.
Last as long as possible. What they see right there is a win. And so they want everybody around our hero to just stew in it. To just extend, to just stew in it. Oh, we're gonna, you know, let him get discouraged, let him get more broke, I mean, other defendants, let him get more, you know, beat down by the system, and oh, I just had to enter an uninformed guilty plea. He just dodged your violence skillfully.
May? May? Do we got a DA?
Coward. Can't win with words, so he's got to win with violence. No different than a high school bully. So they scheduled him a date, and you can come back at this time.
On all matters.
On all matters.
You understand?
Do you understand? Creepy.
I do not. I have not been informed of the cause of my
changes. Yes! Yes! Yes. So, do you understand, after being all nice, and our hero comes back with, I have not been informed of the cause and nature of the proceeding. On the transcript, let's see how he responds.
And if you say anything else.
Be quiet. If you say anything else. He just said, if you say anything else. He threatened him with violence again, right here on the spot. And if our hero says something right now, the judge will throw him in jail. If you hear this at you in a courtroom, you are about to get thrown in jail. Don't say another word. Now, I know that our hero didn't go to jail here, so if he does say something after this, he got away with it. But I'm just saying, generally speaking, viewer, don't say another word. The last thing he said on the record was, I am entering an uninformed plea of not guilty. And then the last thing was, I have not been informed of the cause and nature of the proceeding. Let it hang. Send that to the appeals court. All right? Send that to the superior judge. Send it to the judge sideways. This guy's getting dismissed because he's never going to recuse himself, obviously.
As this is a community court decline, the state's offer for dismissal would expire today with Mr.
So the prosecutor just put on the record that because our hero entered an uninformed guilty plea, which they're just pretending is a straight-up not guilty plea, uninformed not guilty plea, that he's saying on the record that the plea deal just goes away, effective right today, now.
Thank you. You understand it's just for the offer that this will be extended. It's fine, so you have until this afternoon. Get in touch with Mr. Webb and I'll speak. If you change your mind and don't want to go through the trial process and risk criminal conviction, risk going to jail, and fines.
Jesus. So, piece of Judge Johnston, of course, he'll take option two for a trial and not guilty plea, but of course that will just expose him to more recordings and being drawn out from his tactics. So right now he's putting pressure. Oh, this is, it's like a salesman saying there's a sale that ends today, it's one time buy or something. Oh, if you change your mind, if we've scared you sufficiently, you can always get in touch with the prosecutor over here and accept the deal, and then you'll have 8 hours of community service, remember? But if you go to trial, you could do jail time and be convicted of a crime. If you think it's so serious, why is the state offering me 8 hours?
I don't understand that there are substantial fines that go along with this. And that's the advantage of having an attorney. Someone can explain that to you.
And that's the advantage of having an attorney. Someone can explain that to you. You mean manipulate you and try and scare you into accepting the will of the state? People like me are coming, Judge Johnston.
One of them is up a year in jail and a $6,250 fine.
One guy just spent a year in jail and a $652 fine.